and many bees will be robbed of their stores and their food, and will be cruelly submerged and drowned by folks devoid of reason. O justice of God, why dost thou not awake to behold thy creatures thus abused? Leonardo da Vinci, vegetarian.
In Tibet, you would be warmly greeted everywhere with Tashi Delek, in Tibetan, meaning hello. I'm Yeshe, a Tibetan yogi. The prayerful people of Tibet wish that heaven will always watch over the pure-hearted like you. Throughout the history of mankind, the divine messages are often shrouded in mystery. Prophets, messiahs, or whichever names you call them, are often persecuted and oppressed, their words obscured. But how do we distinguish the true from the false? To do so, one can only rely on the divine's guidance, and the truth will reveal itself to those who earnestly seek it. Shambhala, meaning source of happiness and peace in Sanskrit, is a mysterious, sacred kingdom said to exist somewhere in Central Asia, possibly north of Mount Kailash of the Tibetan Himalayas. Over the centuries, many intrigued scholars and explorers have tried to locate and/or travel to this elusive place, but were mostly unsuccessful. In his book, Shambhala, the respected Russian archaeologist, painter, and writer Nicholas Roerich suggests the reason why Shambhala is so difficult to find.
Shambhala есть священное место, где земной мир соприкасается с высшим состоянием сознания. На Востоке они знают, что существует две Шамбалы, одна земная и другая невидимая.
Shambhala is described as a paradise of eternal peace and joy, where all citizens have achieved great enlightenment and wisdom, live long lives, and are free of poverty, sickness, killing, hatred, and lying. This paradise is also said to have inspired the novel Lost Horizon, which led to several films featuring a fictional Tibetan valley called Shangri-La.
Have you ever dreamed of a place far away from it all, where the air you breathe is soft and clean, and children play in fields of green, and the sound of guns doesn't pound in your ears.
In this classic film, a group of newcomers is secretly brought to a sunny utopian place, hidden amidst a harsh land of snow and a warring outside world. The film helped pique the modern world's interest in Shambhala. However, Shambhala has been spoken of since ancient times, including in the Kalachakra Tantra, a central scripture of Tibetan Buddhism, and the text of the pre-Buddhist Zhangzhun culture from Western Tibet. In her book, The Secret Doctrine, the esteemed Russian philosopher and founder of Theosophy, Madame Helena Blavatsky, revealed the following about the history of Shambhala.
There, Lemuria's elect had taken shelter on the sacred island, now the fabled Shambhala, in the Gobi Desert. Alone, the handful of those elect, whose divine instructors had gone to inhabit that sacred island from whence the last savior were come, now kept mankind from becoming one half the exterminator of the other, as mankind does now.
From these words, we discover that Shambhala is a place where the enlightened members of an ancient race had taken refuge from a past planetary cataclysm and have been helping us, the unenlightened human race, from destroying ourselves. One of our association members was able to attest to similar information and more through her inner vision.
香巴拉是我前世生活过的地方，我还记得那里的景象。那是一个地底下的世界，处在第六维度，入口是被无形力量严密守护着的。这个神秘的传说中的地方是在很久很久以前由格萨尔王设置的。那时格萨尔王是另一种身份，以前古地球曾与其他星球发生星际战争。那次灾难中，有些好人转入了地底下的香巴拉。他们刚刚找到香巴拉的时候，并不知道那里原本就有高等无形的众生存在，因为看不到。可是香巴拉那个空间具有神奇的提升灵性的能力，这些地表人被提升之后，天眼开了，慢慢的就能看到那些无形更高等的众生。这些爱心满满的人拥有高科技，为了保护地球，就一直留在香巴拉生活。香巴拉主要的功能是维持地球的能量平衡，有各种神奇的机制来维持住地球的生机与存续。香巴拉里面有一个人造的太阳，树木都是闪闪发光的，那里的人身高约有3到4公尺高，彼此之间都用心灵感应来沟通，所以很少开口说话，人口约有几十万，寿命很长很长。当我住在那里的时候，不太需要进食，不过有些人也会吃一点香甜的蔬果，是吃纯素的。这里要生出小孩，是类似像天堂或较高境界一样的，由圣人们用意念在莲花里培养一段时间，才造出小孩。每个小孩培养的时间长短不一，有的要培养很久，有的比较快。空气循环就是用一个很大的机器来循环跟净化，机器的能量动力是从水晶里面提取的。我们还拥有幽浮，能乘坐幽浮造访其他星球。有时候缺某种物资的时候，我们也会变换成人类的样子到地球地表买物资。这里的整平与天堂还有宇宙里都不相同，是一个灵性宝藏之地。我们爱心满满，很喜欢建设香巴拉，都是自愿资源共享，互相帮助，谁能造出什么就跟别人换自己需要的东西，并不存在货币系统， 是一个以物易物的、非常和谐、和平、充满爱心的理想国度。
According to the Kalachakra Tantra, Shambhala has been and will be ruled over by a lineage of 32 enlightened kings, 7 Dharma kings, followed by 25 Rigdan kings, with Rigdan meaning holder of all the castes. It is predicted that the 25th Rigdan king, Rudra Chakrin, also known as Rigdan Japo, will be the final king of Shambhala, and that he will lead a holy battle to defeat the barbarians or demons that will try to invade Shambhala. Interestingly, Tibetan Buddhist teachers know that King Gesar of Tibet, Manjusri Bodhisattva, and Rudra Chakrin are all one and the same, as is the venerated Tibetan Buddhist Master Padmasambhava.
In nature, you are the Vajra Manjushri. In manifestation, you are a divine king of the world. In ancient times, you were the knowledge holder Padmasambhava. In the present, you are Senching Novu Jadol Gesar. In the future, you will be Rigdan Rudra Chakrin.
And in Buddhism, the king of Shambhala is the same as the worshipped future Maitreya Buddha. As the celebrated Russian writer Helena Rurich said,
Конечно, все буддисты верят, что Майтрея появится в Шамбале, и наиболее просвещенные из них знают, что Майтрея и нынешний владыка Шамбалы – единая индивидуальность.
Here, Helena Rurich used the phrase present Lord of Shambhala, revealing that the mighty Rudra Chakrin is already on the throne. We know that the final king of Shambhala is the beloved Supreme Master Qinghai, based on the inner visions of our association members confirming Master's manifestations as a Maitreya Buddha, Manjusri Bodhisattva, and King Gesar.
8年前我还未应心，曾在梦境中看到了一个景象，没想到竟在 Racing Center 成立的庆典中应验了。映入眼帘的是那碎石弯道及两旁的奇花异草，只见同修们以一个个井然有序地坐下，一根根的水泥柱及阁楼的回旋楼梯深深地吸引住了我。好熟悉的景象啊，8年前的梦中，弥勒佛正坐在师父所坐的位置上讲经，地上坐满了人。弥勒佛看到我，笑嘻嘻地对我说：你来啦，快坐下来。我好奇地问：这是什么地方？弥勒佛说：这是兜率宫。短短数月，竟将此地化为了天堂的兜率宫。
제가바로스승님이아미륵부처님이시구나하는것을저는금방알아봤죠
台南那位蔡师兄会看到师父是文殊菩萨的化身。
内在体验中，突然亮出师父这张很久以前的法相，紧握拳头，神态威武。这张照片是类似格萨尔王造型。
etc.
我跟化身师父在青藏高原的冰原上面飞得好快好快呀，我们飞越了好多高山深谷，美丽的河川，瞬间来到一个设有隐形屏障，完全不会被人发现之处，这是香巴拉的入口。进入香巴拉后，见到里面有很多金色圆顶的宫殿，看起来都像是用黄金做的，很辉煌。我们进入一个宫殿，见到了一位圣王，他的庄严法相非常非常巨大，所以一开始我的眼睛只能局部看到他的左肩膀，他的肩膀发射出极灿烂的金光，后来努力调整心灵之眼再看，才勉强看到这位王穿着战甲，头上戴着王冠， 脸上有白胡子，坐在王座上，是一位老年样貌的圣王。他说，我是格萨尔王，现在是香巴拉王。香巴拉是很多年前我设置的，这是我休息的地方。当这条隐形通道再度打通的时候，雪域高原上将会开出一种像圣杯形状的花。他从王座上站起来拥抱我，我虽看不清楚极亮光芒中巨大的他，但他能够拥抱我，用他深厚的爱。他欢喜地说，孩子啊，你回来了，这个旅程很漫长，但现在是最后阶段了。这次的串联将千年的线都收起来，陪着格萨尔王历经寒暑，你完成任务了。我感动之余也觉得疑惑，格萨尔王不就是师父的前身吗？为何师父又带我来见格萨尔王？身旁的化生师父说，格萨尔王就是我，是我的一位分身，二位能同时存在，这分身可以方便统辖香巴拉的居民。
Над снежными вершинами Гималаев полыхает светлое сияние, ярче звезд и причудливее зорниц. Кто же возжег эти столбы света, шествующие по небу? От Шамбалы они, от башни великого приходящего. Майтрея идет.
What will the king of Shambhala do to establish the golden age? Will ordinary humans someday be able to enter the kingdom of Shambhala? We'll find out as our series continues.